Welcome to my channel. Today you'll get 4 tips to ensure your relationship counseling is successful. If you're looking for relationship or marriage counseling, then here are the most important things that I think you should look out for. First, I've written quite a few articles about the issues before, but there can still be benefits, I would say, in using a couple of marriage counselor. So if you made the decision and want to get counseling, then here is what to look for to ensure you get a good one. 1. Someone with a background in emotional focused therapy, also called EFT. Why is this important? The most common cycle of conflict that repeats and expresses itself in different forms are attachment related. So someone that understands attachment theory and how to work with different attachment styles will be able to help you identify that negative cycle you might be stuck in and help you break it. This will reduce conflict and help you both connect more. It's also the couple therapy with the highest success rate of around 75%. Here are some questions to ask a potential couples therapist. 1. Do you have any training in emotional focused therapy? 2. What is it about EFT that's so helpful to couples? And the next one, can I speak to any of your previous clients about their experience? The second thing to look for in a therapist is somatic experience, somatic method, or similar training in bodily therapy. Therapy is often too focused on our cognitive ability, thought and speech, and neglect our bodily sensations. In a simplified version, our brain has 3 essential layers. Sensation that regulates our body, such as hunger, thirst, if we are hot or cold, and so on. And then we have emotions that motivate and connect us. Finally, we have cognition of thought that is a primary focus in our culture. Talking therapy alone has been shown in many cases to have a very low success rate. That does not mean that it doesn't have any value, as we do use words to understand the world around us. And if we can change how we interpret the world through words and our thoughts, we can also experience different emotional responses. However, it neglects the organic feedback loop of how the bodily sensation and emotions also impact our thoughts and action. If we incorporate the body in somatic therapy, we open up a whole new way to express and process our experience. For me and many others, mindful dance such as 5 rhythms has been an amazing way to open up to being present in our experience and process issues that could not be done through thought or conversation alone. I would therefore recommend someone that have the theory and knowledge of emotional focus therapy and some somatic or dance therapy background as well. Or why not do both? Everything is stored in the body, and so we can often access and release things through movement in a way we can't as well through conversation. And it's a direct route that often don't even require logical understanding of the issue, and that's why I recommend it so highly. Here are some questions to ask a potential couples therapist. Do you have any training in somatic or dance therapy? What do you find is most helpful for clients when doing somatic or dance therapy? This should give you an idea whether they know what they're talking about and have the required experience to help you release things somatically. 3 is sexuality. All 3 couple therapists that I visited during my marriage did not even bring up sex once. How can anyone provide marriage or couple therapy and skip the topic of sex? It seems to mainly come down to the therapist being uncomfortable with the topic or simply lacking the knowledge to actually know much about human sexuality. Sex is a major part of any relationship and also impacts both relationship and intimacy and our overall happiness. I would therefore recommend, if you want couples therapy or counseling, then ensure the therapist have a great amount of knowledge around sexuality and is comfortable discussing this. Here are some questions to ask a potential couples therapist. Do you have any training in human sexuality? What are some of the best books on human sexuality? Then check out these books and see if your views align with the therapist before you pick them. And always remember the question if you can speak with any of the previous clients. It's the best way to know if they're good at what they do. 4, select someone you connect with. An interesting fact is that one of the most important factors in deciding the outcome of any therapy is the relationship between the client and the therapist. If there's not a connection and trust between you two, then it's unlikely the therapist can have an impact at all. Have you ever experienced a therapist and sit and take notes and is not even looking at you? Not very connecting or safe to expose your most vulnerable part to someone that does not even maintain eye contact, presence, and is not there to show empathy. We are influenced more by people we connect with and trust. It's just common sense. This is why I would avoid a therapist and sit and take their notes rather than being present with you and emphasizing with your experience. If they take notes, tell them to record it instead and simply use a transcribe software that can sort the notes for them afterwards. A good couple therapist or counselor is present and connected. This is subjective, of course, and only you can say if you connect with your therapist, but have a phone call before to get a sense of how the therapist shows empathy for your situation and whether they listen and acknowledge your experience. I once told a therapist that my son was in hospital with a life-limited condition, and she simply said, okay, and moved on, and I just knew instantly she was not the therapist for me. So I hope you can use these tips and good luck finding a therapist. If you want to learn more tools about how to decrease conflict, increase intimacy, and have amazing sex, then go to my website and check out my ebook, and you can find loads there. Until I see you next time, have fun relating. And don't forget to subscribe below or leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed this video. See you on the next video.